In this video, we would discuss what are pattern attributes. When the patterns are given in the form of shapes or in the form of pictures, then they can be described by changing characteristics. Those changing characteristics are called attributes. There are different types of attributes that we would be able to see in a pattern. The first attribute is shape. Second, we can say is size. Third, color. Fourth is position. Position can also be called direction. And fifth attribute is number. Let's understand this with an example. So the first example is, so let's say we're given this example. We're given a blue star, we're given two grass, two blue stars, two grass, two blue stars, two grass. So what do we see is, we see that the two blue stars and the two grass shapes are getting repeated. Whatever gets repeated in a pattern, it's called is, whatever gets repeated in a pattern is called its core. Core is the part of the pattern that repeats. Now, if we want to describe the attributes that are changing in this pattern, it would be, because we have a star and we have a grass shape, so we have two different shapes in this core of the pattern. So we would say that shape is changing in this pattern. So first is shape. How is shape changing? Shape is changing from star to grass. What's the next attribute that we see is changing is, we have two stars and we have two grass. So basically, the number is not changing, because the stars are also 2 and grass is also 2. So there is no change in the number. Next we see is the color is changing, because we have blue star and we have green grass. So color is changing from blue to green. Is the size changing? No, we have the same size. So we would say no size change, no number change. Now let's talk about position. Do you think the position is changing? Position or direction, we would consider that the position or direction is not changing in this case. So the two attributes that are changing in this particular example is shape and color. Let's take another example. Now, if we're asked to find out the core of the pattern, so core is, because we see two circles, one square, two circle, one square, two circle, one square is being repeated. So we would say two circles, one square is the core of this pattern. Now, what are the attributes that are changing in this? So we can just look at the core to write on the attributes. We have two blue circles and we have one yellow. So from here, we see that the first thing we can talk about is the shape is changing. So shape is changing from circles to square. Next attribute that we can write down as changing is color. Color is changing from blue to yellow. Next we can write down as number. There are two blue circles and there is one yellow square, so we can say 2 to 1. So we can say two circles to one square, that is changing. So this is how we explain the attributes of a given pattern. Let's take one more example for the sake of practice. Let's first figure out the core of this pattern. To find out the core, we'll just read the pattern. There are two upside facing pink arrows and one right facing blue arrow. Two upside facing pink arrows, one right facing blue arrow, and so on. So two upside facing pink arrows and one right facing blue arrow is the core of this pattern. Now to describe this core, we would write down the attributes. The first attribute that is changing in this pattern is, we can easily see color. So color is changing from pink to blue. Second, do we see any change in shape? This is also an arrow and this is also an arrow, so there is no change in shape. We do not have to describe any shape. Next we can describe is a number. There are two pink arrows and there is one blue arrow. So the number is 2 pink to 1 blue arrow. Third attribute that we have to describe is, in this case, position or direction is also applicable. So we can say direction is changing. Upward is for pink to right is for blue arrow. And another thing we will notice here is changing is the size. So we have pink arrows are the bigger in size and we have blue arrow is the one that is smaller in size. So it's big pink arrows to small blue arrow. And this is how we describe the core and the attributes of a given pattern in the form of shapes.